don't miss any content, don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Hey guys, welcome back to Sahara Football. It's a fine morning here. We're going to talk more football. As usual, I'm your host Selassie Fiyawe, and I'm going to bring you some updates in the world of local football and beyond. So now, before we start, I'd like to remind you guys once again about the jolly goodness. We are going to feed 1,000 plus kids in Winneba, and we are asking for your help and donation to make this a reality for those kids. Remember, this is a season of giving, and it would be very, very great to know that you put a smile on a child's face. You are the reason a child is smiling, and it would be great for to be part of this campaign. Now, yesterday, I started placing the numbers in the description. Today, I'll do same. If you're interested in donating, please send the money to those lines or contact us if you are having a problem donating money from where you are, or if you have any inquiries to make. The numbers are in the description. You can make all those inquiries there, and I think this is a great initiative from the Precious Asian Bayou Foundation. So without much ado, let me get right into my stories. Now, we know when the Black Stars coach Kwesi Appiah made a call up for the team to play Ethiopia last month, there were some arguments that why he couldn't include local players. Now, he has come out to explain why he didn't include any local players in the squad. Yes, he has come out to explain why he didn't include any local players, and this is what Black Stars coach Kwesi Appiah had to say. There is no competition going on in the country. So, what do you base on to call the local players? Kwesi Appiah quizzed on Tuesday. It's difficult to call them once there is no league ongoing, he added. Meanwhile, a special championship confirmed to take off will mark the return of local competitive action for the first time since June after a 6-month break. Competitive football in Ghana resumed in January, the normalization committee has announced. So that's why Kwesi Appiah has not included any local players in the squad. You know, he called three local players he included in the squad last time out was Felix Anand, Asante Kotoko Ibani. Even that was because a lot of people were calling for him to be included in the squad. He was really, really, really good. That keeper is really, really good, and he's really doing well and deserved a call up. Actually, he really deserved a call up. So I move on to my next story, and it's on Asante Kotoko. But before I go to Asante Kotoko, let me talk about yesterday. There was a meet the press by the President of the Republic of Ghana, Nana Akufo-Addo, and he was speaking on the investigation, the results of the ANAS investigation, and what he expects from the normalization committee after the revelations from the ANAS expose. Let's have a listen to what the president of the state had to say about that.
This game that we all adore, there's nobody in this country who loves football more than me. I say that as a matter of record. There's nobody in Ghana who loves football more than me. Anybody who knows me tells you I'm a fanatic. What I'm hoping for out of what has happened is that through this normalization committee that the government and FIFA worked out together to establish, a new beginning in Ghanaian football administration is going to be started, because the process is there for them to make a new constitution and to begin at the beginning and put in a structure that hopefully will prevent the kind of things that we have seen in the past. That is my hope, and I think it should be the hope of all of us. As I say, I'm hoping the people who have been put on this normalization committee, certainly from what I know of all of them, these are very upright, straightforward, intelligent, capable Ghanaians. I think that they're going to lead the process of a more sane football administration, making rules that will be more transparent in the way things are done, and trying to balance the various interests that there are in football. The interests of we, the spectators, audience, the interests of those who put money in football, the interests of the administrators, the interests of the players, the clubs, all it's a whole bundle of things.
So that was the president, Nana Akufo-Addo, there. He was stating that he is really confident in this normalization committee. He knows they have learned from the ANAS expose. They've learned a lot from the ANAS expose, and they will not repeat those same mistakes that led us to where we were, where there was so much corruption was rife in that and that those revelations that were made on June 6th, corruption and all that debt in Ghana football, he's trusting and hoping that the normalization committee will he learn from that and not repeat the same mistakes when restructuring the football in Ghana, being led by the able-handed Dr. Kofi Amwa and his other three members. We are hoping that football will be back on its feet and much more stronger than when it went down. Now, Asante Kotoko, as I said, Asante Kotoko have been accused of petitioning the government for help. Now, Asante Kotoko CEO George Amwako has come out to explicitly deny those claims. Yes, he's saying that that is not the case. Asante Kotoko have not petitioned government for help in their Africa campaign, which they are currently ongoing. And they'll be facing Kariobangi Sharks on Saturday. And the second leg, the first leg was a dire 0-0 draw. And the second leg, they are hoping to overcome Kariobangi Sharks. Now, George Amwako has sought to clear the air on the fact that people are saying they are asking for help from the government of Ghana. Let's have a listen to what George Amwako had to say when queried about this.
There is no such promise. There is no such payment to Kotoko. We have not discussed any such thing. We hope that we will impress everybody, the GFA, the ministry, the government. Kotoko would impress with our performance, so they themselves will come to our aid as we progress. But what you are talking about does not exist.
So that was Kotoko CEO George Amwako, and he has come out to say that no, they have never queried or asked government for help before. Yes, they have never asked government for help before, and that they are hoping that they will do well in this tournament. They have not petitioned for help from government to support them in their Africa campaign, and those rumors are really baseless and false. He has denied them emphatically. But despite that, George Amwako has also come out to say that he, in a tweet yesterday, he stated that the cost of their trip to Kenya for the clash with Kariobangi Sharks cost them over 41,000 Ghana cedis, and because of that, they will need to allay the cost of that on the fans. So they are charging a higher fee for the match on Saturday at the Kumasi Sports Stadium, Baba Yara Sports Stadium, and they are charging 20 cedis for the popular stand instead of the regular 10 cedis or 5 cedis. It's 20 cedis now, and for the VIP and the VIP, I think it's 50 and 80 cedis respectively. So George Amwako there explaining to the fans why the cost of tickets for the Kariobangi Sharks clash has increased like that. Now, Asante Kotoko, sticking with them, they have built another ultra modern training pitch. Yes, you can see in your pictures right now, the ultra modern training pitch is located at Adajako. It's an Adajako project. It is expected to have a mini village, a training pitch, a 40,000 seater capacity stadium, among many other facilities. So Asante Kotoko, they're making serious strides in Ghana football. This is a great move, a big move actually. It's a big move on the part of Asante Kotoko management and Dr. Che. They are making a lot of grounds. They are making a lot of strides in local football, and we hope that on Saturday they will be able to overcome Kariobangi Sharks. We all know they need to win this. Look at the ultra modern training pitch. It's really a nice environment, and I think the players with these kind of facilities, footballers with these kind of facilities, will do well. Yes, they will do well. They will do very well, and we hope and wish them the best on Saturday. Remember, on Saturday to the Black Meteors played the first leg 5-1 win here in Ghana at the Baba Yara Sports Stadium. They beat the Togolese counterparts 5-1 and are going for the second leg in Lome. That will be on Saturday too, yes. So we are hoping that the Black Meteors will also make them proud. Now, the referees for the CAF Confederations Cup clash arrived in Ghana on Wednesday. You can see them here in your pictures. They have arrived in Ghana, and they are from Uganda. So they are Mashut. The referees from Uganda have arrived for the Kotoko clash, and they are Mashut Sally will be the center referee, assisted on the lines by countrymen Lee Okello and Balikowa Musa Ngobi. So the trio touched down at the Kotoko International Airport on Wednesday afternoon, and they were met on the arrival by the club's deputy Accra representative Nana Kwame Dankwa, and flew out to Kumasi hours later. The fourth referee and the match commissioner are set to be on their way to the country. So Kotoko played out a 0-0 draw, as I already told you, in the first leg, and this second leg they are hoping to make up for that with an emphatic win, hopefully, over Kariobangi Sharks. Now, my final story. Ghanaian midfielder David Akam believes Asante Kotoko will defeat Kenyan club Kariobangi Sharks in the CAF Confederations Cup. This is what he said. David Akam is a midfielder. He said, I think Kotoko did well in the first leg since they didn't lose. That's the most important thing for most people. And they didn't concede as well, which is also very good. They should try and beat Kariobangi Sharks here in Ghana to make it to the next round, he told GH1. So that has been it for today, guys. I've been giving you more updates on the Kotoko, Asante Kotoko versus Kariobangi Sharks clash, and the Black Meteors return leg clash against Togo. So that has been it for today, guys. I'll bring you the updates on that. See you guys in the next one. And please remember, jolly goodness, we are spreading jolly goodness to the kids of Winneba. 1,000 plus kids, it can be possible with your small donation. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a great day and enjoy the festive season.